الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأزواجه وأصحابه وعلى من تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. ثم أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. ثم أما بعد، all praises due to Allah who praise Him, who seek His support, assistance and guidance. I testify that there is no God worth of worship except Allah alone, who has no partners. And I testify that Muhammad is His servant and messenger. May Allah's peace and blessings be upon him, his family, his wives and those who follow his way, and call for his deen till the day of judgment. O you who believe, fear Allah as it should be feared, and then accept under the state of Islam. O mankind, fear your Lord who created you from a single soul. From him created his wife. And from them created countless men and women. So fear Allah through whom he demands your mutual rights and the wombs. Indeed, Allah is ever watchful over you. O you who believe, fear Allah and say a word that always direct to the truth, so that he may make your conduct whole and sound and forgive you your sins. Indeed, he who obeys Allah and his messenger has attained the highest achievement. The most truthful speech of the Book of Allah, and the best guidance of that of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and indeed the worst affairs and the newly introduced ones into the deen. For every newly introduced matter into the deen is bid'ah. Every bid'ah is misguidance, and every misguidance leads to the fire. Qala ta'ala, فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرُكُمْ وَاشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ وَقَالَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِّعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ إِذَا مَسَّكُمُ الضُّرُّ فَإِلَيْهِ تَجْأَرُونَ ثُمَّ إِذَا كَشَفَ الضُّرَّ عَنكُمْ إِذَا فَرِيقٌ مِّنكُم بِرَبِّهِمْ يُشْرِكُونَ وَقَالَ جَلَّ وَعَلَا وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَغَفُورٌ رَّحِيمٌ وَقَالَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَظَلُومٌ كَفَّارٌ. Allah the Exalted says, so remember me, I will remember you, and be grateful to me and do not deny me. And he also says, and whatever blessings and favors you have, it is from Allah. Then when harm touches you, unto him you cry out loud for help. Then when he has removed the harm from you, behold, some of you associate others in worship with the Lord. And Allah the Exalted says, and if you will count the favors of Allah, never could you be able to count them. Truly Allah is oft forgiving, most merciful. And Allah also says, and if you count the blessings of Allah, never will you be able to count them. Verily man is indeed an extreme wrongdoer, a disbeliever. وَالشُّكْرُ يكون بالقلب خضوعا واستكانة واعترافا بأن المنعم بها هو الله وحده لا شريك له والتحدث بها والثناء على الله بها والاستعانة بها على طاعة المنعم وعبادته. قال تعالى مبينا حال من يجحد نعم الله يعرفون نعمة الله ثم ينكرونها وأكثرهم الكافرون. قال ابن كثير رحمه الله يعرفون أن الله هو المسدي إليهم ذلك وهو المتفضل بها عليهم ومع ذلك ينكرون ذلك ويعبدون معه غيره ويسندون النصر والرزق إلى غيره والشكر يكون بالقلب واللسان ويصدقه العمل. قال تعالى: اعملوا آل داود شكرا. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم: أفلا أكون عبدا شكورا. Being grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is done by the heart, by submitting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by lowering yourself before Allah, by being convinced of the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who surrounded you with all the bounties and the blessings and the favors you have. Only Allah. And also being thankful to Allah to speak of these bounties that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has descended upon you, and to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to seek these bounties, to seek their assistance in getting you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by using them and obeying Allah azza wa jal, by using them in worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah the Exalted have explained the situation of those who are surrounded by the bounties of Allah, yet they are ungrateful, by saying they recognize the grace of Allah, yet they deny it, meaning by being ungrateful. And most of them are disbelievers. Ibn Kathir, may Allah have mercy upon him, said, they know for a fact that Allah is the one who descended the blessings and the bounties upon them. And they know for a fact that it is only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But they deny it and they worship others beside Allah. And they submit the fact that the sustainer is not Allah. And they say, the support and protection and victory at risk is from others. Being grateful is done by the heart, the tongue, and authenticates it, the actions. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, work, O family of Dawood, with gratitude. Indeed, few of my servants are grateful. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, shall I not be a thankful servant? ويجنب النعم ارتكاب ما نهى الله عنه من المعاصي والآثام. قال أبو هارون: دخلت على أبي حازم فقلت له: يرحمك الله، ما شكر العينين؟ قال: إذا رأيت بهما خيرا ذكرته، وإذا رأيت بهما شرا سترته. قلت: وما فما شكر الأذنين؟ قال: إذا سمعت بهما خيرا حفظته، وإذا سمعت بهما شرا نسيته. And to also to avoid using these bounties and blessings from Allah and disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For Abu Harun said, I entered upon Abu Hazim and I asked him, may Allah have mercy upon you. How does a person thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the eyes, for the ability to see, for the bounty of sight? He said, when you see good with them, you make a mention of it. But when you see evil with them, you hide it, you conceal it. You do not go and spread it. And he said, and how does a person become thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the bounties of the ears? He said, when you hear good with them, you preserve it, you protect it. But were you to hear any evil with them, you forget about them. قال شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية: العارف بالله يسير إلى الله بين مشاهدة المنة ومطالعة عيب النفس والعمل. وهذا معنى قوله صلى الله عليه وسلم في الحديث الصحيح من حديث بريدة رضي الله عنه: سيد الاستغفار أن يقول العبد: اللهم أنت ربي لا إله إلا أنت، خلقتني وأنا عبدك، وأنا على عهدك ووعدك ما استطعت، أعوذ بك من شر ما صنعت، أبوء لك بنعمتك علي وأبوء بذنبي فاغفر لي، فإنه لا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت. فجمع في قوله صلى الله عليه وسلم: أبوء لك بنعمتك علي وأبوء بذنبي، بين مشاهدة المنة ومطالعة عيب النفس والعمل. مشاهدة المنة أي رؤية نعم الله جل وعلا على الإنسان، أناء الليل وأطراف النهار، نعم لا تعد ولا تحصى. ومطالعة عيب النفس والعمل أي دائما يرى تقصيره في طاعة الله جل وعلا ويرى معصيته. فالمؤمن دائما على وجل، هو شاكرا لله جل وعلا على نعمه آناء الليل وأطراف النهار، ويرى ذنوبه وتقصيره في طاعة الله جل وعلا فيتوب إلى الله جل وعلا ويستغفره. فمشاهدة المنة توجب المحبة والحمد والشكر لولي النعم والإحسان على نعمه التي لا تعد ولا تحصى، ومطالعة عيب النفس والعمل توجب الذل والانكسار والافتقار والتوبة إليه في كل وقت. ولا طريق إلى الله أقرب من العبودية. شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية may Allah have mercy upon him said, the knowledgeable person of Allah is always walking toward the path of Allah between two things. He's seen and well aware of the bounties and the favors of Allah upon him, and he sees his shortcomings and his sins and his mistakes, and how his obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is lacking, and how his actions toward worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are also lacking. And this is the meaning of the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the authentic hadith narrated by Buraydha, may Allah be pleased with him, who said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the master dua of istighfar, the best prayers or dua for seeking the forgiveness of Allah, is for the person to say, Allahumma anta rabbi, la ilaha illa ant, خلقتني وأنا عبدك وأنا على عهدك ووعدك ما استطعت، أعوذ بك من شر ما صنعت، أبو لك بنعمتك علي وأبو بذنبي فاغفر لي، فإنه لا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت. Oh Allah, you are my Lord, there is no God but you. You have created me and I am your servant, and I am keeping my promise and covenant to you as much as I can. I seek refuge with you from the evil of what I do. I acknowledge your blessings and I acknowledge my sin. I acknowledge your blessings and I acknowledge my sins. So forgive me, for there is none who can forgive sin except you. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam combined both statements, that I acknowledge your favors, your blessings, your bounties, O Allah, and I also acknowledge my sins. أبوء لك بنعمتك علي وأبوء بذنبي. So the servant is between two cases. He's acknowledging the bounties and the blessings of Allah that surrounds him throughout parts of the day and throughout the depths of the night, in the hours of the night. He's well aware every ni'mah he has is from Allah. The ability to see, the sound health, the ability to speak and comprehend, the ability to stand and sit is from Allah. The ni'mah of Islam is from Allah. The ni'mah of guidance is from Allah. The ni'mah of being grateful and thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which by itself is a bounty, is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he sees the bounties of Allah that requires you to love Allah, to praise Allah, to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his countless bounties and his countless favors upon you. And you acknowledge your sin, you acknowledge your mistakes and your shortcomings, you acknowledge the fact that you do not worship Allah as he should be worshipped, nor do you use these actions and these bounties and these favors to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which then implements upon you humiliation before Allah, submission before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and therefore continuous repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seeking his forgiveness, begging for his mercy. And you know that the closest path is in worship in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. والعبودية مدارها على قاعدتين وما أصلها حب كامل مشاهدة المنة وذل تام مطالعة عيب النفس. ذل تام لتقصيره في الطاعة وخوفا من معصية الله جل وعلا. Therefore worshiping Allah is upon always two foundations, two major principles, two fundamentals fact. Worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is upon complete love towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by seeing his countless bounties and favors upon you, and complete submissions before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you see your mistakes and your shortcomings and your sins, so you fear him, you rush to him, you beg for his mercy and you fear his punishment. You fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who granted you the ni'ams, but you turned around and you used it to disobey him. The one who granted you the bounties, but you turned around Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala surrounded you with bounties. From the moment you were created, to the moment you will be placed in your grave. And for many of us, we hope that it will continue afterward by making our grave a garden from the gardens of Jannah and making our hereafter to be in Jannah. Al-Firdaws al-A'la wa fil Jannah. Therefore, the servant of Allah worships Allah with complete between love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, great hope in Allah, great love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His countless bounties, and fear of Allah azza wa jal due to your sins and your mistakes and your shortcomings. أسأل الله العلي العظيم أن يسبغ علينا نعمه ظاهرة وباطنة وأن يجعلنا ممن إذا أنعم عليه شكر وإذا ابتلي صبر وإذا أذنب تاب وأناب واستغفر فإن هذه الأمور الثلاثة عنوان سعادة العبد وعلامة فلاحه في الدنيا والآخرة ولا ينفك عبد عنها أبدا فإن العبد دائم التقلب بين هذه الأطباق الثلاثة إذا أنعم عليه الله شكر وإذا ابتلي صبر وإذا أذنب تاب وأناب واستغفر. I ask Allah, the great, to continue descending His bounties upon us, the hidden and the apparent one, and to make us all among those that when Allah descends a bounty upon them, they become grateful. And when Allah tests them, they become patient. And when they commit sins, they return and repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they seek His forgiveness. These three matters are the title of the happiness of the servant in this worldly life, and the sign and the mark of his happiness in the hereafter. And the servant never leaves one of these three categories. For indeed, he's always between them, between these three categories. When Allah descends bounties upon him, when Allah grants him a ni'mah, he's grateful, he's thankful to Allah. When Allah tests him, when Allah afflicts him, he's patient for the sake of Allah. And when he commits a sin, he rushes back to Allah. He repents to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He seeks His forgiveness. Al-awwal, na'mu min Allahi jalla wa ala, tataradafu alayhi ana al-layli wa atraf al-nahar. Wa ni'matu sayyid, wa shukru qayyid, wa mu'dhinun bil mazid. Qala ta'ala, وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَئِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَئِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. وشكر النعمة مبني على ثلاثة أركان: الاعتراف بها باطنا، والتحدث بها ظاهرا، وتصريفها في مرضاة وليها ومزديها ومعطيها. والثاني محن من الله تعالى يبتليه بها، ففرضوا فيها الصبر والتسلي، وصبر حبس النفس عن التسخط بالمقدور، وحبس اللسان عن الشكوى، وحبس الجوارح عن المعصية كاللطم وشق الثياب ونتف الشعر والدعاء بدعوى الجاهلية. The first category is the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descend upon you continuously throughout the day and throughout the night. Continuously. When you return home safe, it's a blessing from Allah. When you see your children with sound health, it's a blessing from Allah. When you're sitting under a roof, not being feared by eviction, not being feared by insecurity and the loss of safety, that by itself is one of the greatest bounties and blessings from Allah subhanahu. The ability to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a ni'mah, blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the blessings of Allah descend upon us throughout the day and the night. And the ni'am, the bounties of Allah, are like hunting. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends them to you. In order to keep them and not let him go, you have to be grateful to Allah. Allah is the greatest example when someone goes and hunts something. And then lets it go, it will go. But when he hunts it, when he goes fishing and he holds it and puts it not back where he got it from, then it will stay with him. And therefore they say, ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a catch. In order to keep that catch, you have to be thankful and grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so it doesn't go. And then not only that it will stay, but Allah will increase His bounties upon you. For Allah the Exalted says, and remember when your Lord proclaimed, if you give thanks, I will give you more, meaning of my blessings. But if you become ungrateful, verily my punishment is indeed severe. So if you are continuously thankful to Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not only will keep the ni'am you have and that you're thankful for, but Allah will increase them. But if you are ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and these ni'am will soon after diminish by the command of Allah. And to be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the bounties and the blessings, it is built upon three pillars. First, you attest to the fact in your heart that these bounties are from Allah. And to speak about it, speak about the blessings of Allah. A lot of people, when someone asks him how you're doing, he's doing nothing but complaining. Complaining about family, about children, about health, about wealth. Nothing but complaints, wal-iyadu billah. Not a word of gratitude is addressed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not a word of praise worth is addressed to Allah azza wa jal. Not a word for the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you the ability to speak is by itself a ni'mah. That the fact that you have a house to return to by itself is a ni'mah. But we see when people became thankless, when they became ungrateful, they became easily seduced by the khawarij and the rawafid. And they have lost, some of them, their deen. And they have lost the lands, and they have lost security and safety. Teach your tongue, your family, to be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all times. To be patient when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala afflicts you. To return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you commit a sin. To seek His forgiveness and beg for His mercy at all times. That is the situation of a sound believer. That is the situation of a thankful servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you attest to it in your heart. You speak about it and you make a mention of it by turning gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And thirdly, you use Him to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You use Him to please Allah. The wealth that Allah has given you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask you on the day of resurrection on how you spend it. Your senses, ability to see, speak, comprehend, understand, sit, stand, move, all these, the servant will be asked about them on the day of resurrection. Your free time by itself is a ni'mah from Allah. How did you use it? Did you make your tongue wet by the remembrance of Allah? Did you use your time to remember Allah, to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So these are ni'am in which the servant will be asked about. So therefore you use him as a form of gratitude to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Secondly, understand that the test and the trials and tribulations from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah attests the servant was, it is obligatory upon you to be patient. Indeed, being patient is that you control your soul from being displeased toward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from being displeased toward what Allah has decreed upon you, and to control your tongue from complaining, and to control your limbs from committing sins like the slapping of the faces, and the tearing of the clothes, and the pulling of the hair, as we see sadly. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strikes a person with a trial, with an affliction, with a test, he holds his soul from being ungrateful and displeased. He holds his tongue from complaining and returns to Allah. And he says, "Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un." And he controls his limbs from violating the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أسأل الله جل وعلا أن يجعلنا جميعا من عباده الشاكرين وأن يصلي ويسلم ويبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. الحمد لله، الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأزواجه وأصحابه وعلى من تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم: فمن رضي فله الرضا ومن سخط فعليه السخط. فإذا قام به العبد كما ينبغي انقلبت المحنة في حقه منحة، واستحالت البلية عطية، وصار المكروه محبوبا. فإن الله سبحانه وتعالى لم يبتله ليهلك، وإنما ابتلاه ليمتحن صبره وعبوديته. فإن لله على العبد عبودية في السراء والضراء، وفيما يحب وفيما يكره، فمن أتى بهما فله الكفاية التامة من ربه سبحانه وتعالى، كما قال جل وعلا: أليس الله بكاف عبده؟ The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, so whoever is content, then for him is pleasure. And whosoever is discontent, then for him is wrath. Whosoever is satisfied, Allah will grant him satisfaction at all times. Whosoever is dissatisfied, he has ni'am, but he's always dissatisfied. He's always complaining. Or she is. Even though the smallest ni'mah that the person could have, in which he might look at as insignificant, when it is gone, his life is turned upside down. But they never thanked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that ni'mah. Or many. So therefore the servant is always turned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and is always being pleased and satisfied with every ni'mah that Allah grants him, hoping that Allah will increase it upon him. And the best that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants him, satisfaction. Is that the person is satisfied with what Allah has given him. And the Prophet ﷺ said, and whoever is dissatisfied, then Allah will decree upon him wrath and dissatisfaction. For indeed, when the servant performs as commanded, and being patient toward trials and tribulations, that trial in his case will be a gift. And that test in his case will be a grant from Allah. For indeed, increase his rank. And increase his righteous deeds. And what he hated became a loved act. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not test him to destroy him. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests the servant to test his patience. And to test his worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For it is incumbent upon us towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to worship him. At the times of ease and at the times of hardship. And what we love and what we dislike. And whosoever worships Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that case, he is patient when Allah tests him. He is grateful when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants him ni'am. He returns to Allah and he seeks his forgiveness when he commits sin. Then Allah will grant him the complete protection. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَلَيْسَ اللَّهُ بِكَافٍ عَبْدَهُ. Is not Allah sufficient for his slave? Is not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sufficient to provide protection from him, for him? To provide preservance for him? To provide assistance to him, to provide support to him. Just return to Allah. Rely upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the greatest enemy of mankind, Iblis, Shaytan, إِنَّ عِبَادِي لَيْسَ لَكَ عَلَيْهِمْ سُلْطَانٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the greatest enemy of mankind, Iblis, certainly you shall have no authority over my servants. But to get into that category, follow the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Become thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the ni'am that Allah continues to descend upon you throughout the day and throughout the hours of the night. Become thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for every blessing you have. And were you to count the blessings, the graces, were you to count the favors of Allah, the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you, you would never be able to count. And were you ever to try to worship Allah and obey Him and hope that it would be enough, you would never worship Allah enough. But you turn to Him and you ask for His forgiveness. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts the return of the servant who is sincere. And Allah increases the ni'am upon the servant who is thankful to Him, who is patient for His sake, and who is continuously returning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. نسأل الله جل وعلا أن يجعلنا جميعا من عباده الشاكرين وأن يهدينا جميعا ويهدي بنا ويجعلنا هداة مهتدين. اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا وعافنا واعف عنا. اللهم اغفر لنا ما قدمنا وما أخرنا وما أسرنا وما أعلنا وما أنت أعلم به منا. أنت المقدم وأنت المؤخر، لا إله إلا أنت. اللهم إنا نسألك العافية، ونسألك دوام العافية، ونسألك تمام العافية، ونسألك كمال العافية، ونسألك دوام الغنى عن الناس. اللهم إنا نسألك دوام الغنى عن الناس. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا. اللهم اشفنا واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين. اللهم عافنا وعاف مبتلانا ومبتلى المسلمين. اللهم ارحمنا وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين. اللهم ارحمنا وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأزواجه الطيبين الطاهرين على من تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، وعنا معهم برحمتك وكرمك يا أكرم الأكرمين.